Good morning, everybody. Welcome to school with me, Miss Ashley, today. Today is Monday. Can you say Monday? Very good. All right, while we wait for all of our friends to join us, let's sing our song, Shake My Sillies Out by Raffi. Are you ready?
Gotta shake, shake, shake my sillies out, shake, shake, shake my sillies out, shake, shake,
there we go.
Shake my sillies out, wiggle my waggles out, way. I gotta clap, clap, clap my
remember,
crazies
clap
out,
up high,
clap,
and
clap,
clap
my
down
crazies
low.
Out, clap, clap, clap my crazies out, and wiggle my waggles out, way. I gotta jump, jump,
jump
my jiggles out, jump, jump, jump my jiggles out, jump, jump, jump my jiggles out, and wiggle my waggles out, way. I gotta yawn, yawn,
whoa,
yawn my sleepies out, yawn, yawn, yawn my sleepies
stretch?
Out, yawn, yawn, yawn my sleepies whoa out, and wiggle my waggles out, way. I gotta shake, shake, shake my sillies out, shake, shake, shake my sillies out, shake, shake, shake my sillies out, and wiggle my waggles out, way, and wiggle my waggles out, way.
Thank you for shaking your sillies out with me this morning. All right, friends, my name is Miss Ashley, and I'm so glad that you're here with me today. Should we wake up our friend Barbara? She's really sleepy today. Sometimes on Mondays, it's really hard for us to wake up. Does that ever happen to you? It happens to me, so I really need your help to wake up Barbara, okay? When I count to three, we'll say, get up, Barbara! Can you help me do that? Okay, let's do it. Ready? One, two, three. Get up, Barbara! I don't think she heard us. Let's try again, this time a little bit louder. Ready? One, two, three. Get up, Barbara! Oh, she's peeking her head up. I think she heard us. Let's try one more time as loud as you can. Ready? One, two, three. Get up, Barbara! Hi, Barbara. Did we wake you up? Oh, yes, you did, Miss Ashley. Good morning, everybody. How are you today? Oh, I'm so glad to hear it, Miss Ashley. I'm so excited. Today is Green Day. Did you remember that today is Green Day? Are you wearing green today like me? Oh, my goodness, Barbara, I love your green necklace. Look at that, boys and girls. Doesn't she have a pretty green necklace? I love it. Well, thank you, Miss Ashley. I wanted to wear green today like you, so I put on my pretty green necklace. Well, I love it, Barbara. Thanks for wearing green with me today. We have a lot of fun things to do, so we'll say bye to Barbara. Can you tell her bye? Bye, Barbara. See you later. Goodbye, everyone. See you next time. Bye-bye. All right, friends. Today when I looked out my window, I noticed what the weather was like. Remember, every day we say, how's the weather today? So I used my binoculars and I looked out the window and it was not snowy today. It was not cloudy. It was not rainy or windy. Remember how we could make wind with our mouth? Good job. But it was sunny. Today where I live, it's sunny. How's the weather where you live? Can you look out your window and see what the weather's like where you live? I'll put my sunny picture up right here, like that. I love when it's sunny outside. All right, today we're learning about the color green. We've learned about the color red and orange and yellow. And the next color in our rainbow is green. Do you remember? remember? Is green a primary color or a secondary color? Which color is green? Primary or secondary? Shout it out really loud. Did you say secondary? You're right. Green is a secondary color. Do you remember what two colors we mixed together to make green? Did you say blue and yellow? You're right. Blue and yellow together make green. Maybe I can show you some green when I put these two bottles together. Can you see a little green in there when I hold them like that? Because blue and yellow make green, and green is Miss Ashley's favorite color. What's your favorite color? I like that color too. All right, here's a little poem about the color green. And if you know how to read, you can read the words with me. It goes like this. Green is the grass, string beans and peas. Green is the branches on Christmas trees. All of these things are green. Okay, yesterday I looked all around my house for things that were green. Would you like me to show you what I found? Okay, I'll show you. I found a green apple slicer. You might have one of these in your kitchen. You can put an apple under it and press down really hard, and it cuts your apples into slices. But it's kind of sharp, so you might need a grown-up to help you with that. I also found in my pretend kitchen a green toaster. How fun is that? There's even some toast in there. I like this green toaster. I also found in my pretend kitchen a green pear. Do you like to eat pears? I do. A pear is a yummy kind of fruit we can eat. I also found a green clothespin. Can you help me open it like this? Squeeze your fingers together and it opens and closes. That's a green clothespin. I found lots of green shapes. Let's see if you know these shapes. I bet you know this one. A green star. Good job. And this shape is light green. Let me show you a dark green shape. Do you know this one? It's a rectangle. So both of these are green, but this one is light and this one is dark. And I can put them here on my board because they're magnets. There they go. I also found a green, what's this one? Triangle, that's right. And a green oval. Look at all those green shapes I found. I also found something else in my kitchen that's green. Have you seen something like this before? Do you know what it's used for? I'll show you. It's really cool. Have you heard of a lime? A lime looks like this. I cut it in half. If you eat a lime, they're really sour. Can you make a sour face? Ooh! Limes and lemons are really, really sour. Ooh! So I put my lime in here like this. There it goes. And then I'm gonna get a cup so I don't make a mess. I squeeze it down. And look, that's lime juice. Wow. I have to use my really strong muscles to squeeze it. And look at all that juice that came out of that lime. Then I can use the juice to cook or bake with. Limes are really, really yummy, but kind of sour. I also found some green celery. This is real celery. Do you like celery? Yeah, I do. It's a really yummy snack. So those are all the green things that I found in my house. After school, I want you to see if you can find lots of green things in your house, okay? Excuse me. Okay. We will play a game today. We've been playing lots of games over here, haven't we? These games are fun. This one is called Lucky Shamrock. Do you know what a shamrock is? I'll show you. A shamrock looks like this. Sometimes it has four leaves. One, two, three, four. Sometimes it only has three. And some people think that shamrocks are really lucky. So if you find one, you'll have lots of good luck. And this is called a leprechaun. Can you say that word with me? Leprechaun. That's kind of a tricky word, isn't it? So this leprechaun is going to hide the shamrock behind some pots of gold. That celery kind of got stuck in my throat. So let's look at our pots of gold, and you can help me with the colors. We have red, that one's kind of hard to see, orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple. And what's this other color over here? Let's look. This one is called lime. Just like the lime that I showed you, this color is lime, so it's light green. And my other green is dark, so I have two greens up there today. All right, so I need your help to help find the shamrock that tricky leprechaun is gonna hide, okay? So our poem goes like this. Tricky little leprechaun doesn't want to share. Pick a pot of gold to see if his shamrock is there. Well, that's kind of a long poem, isn't it? All right, I'll hold it up here so he can hide the shamrock. Ready? Tricky little leprechaun doesn't want to share. Pick a pot of gold to see if his shamrock is there. Good job. All right, I need your help. Which pot of gold do you think he hid the shamrock behind? Yell it out really loud so I can hear. Ooh, did you say blue? Let's look behind the blue pot of gold. Nope, the shamrock wasn't behind blue. Let's try again. Yell out what color you think the shamrock is behind. Ooh, I heard lots of friends yelling red. Did you say red? Let's look behind red. It wasn't behind red. Let's try again. Yell it out as loud as you can. What color of pot of gold is that shamrock behind? Ooh, yellow. I heard lots of people say yellow. Let's check. It was behind the yellow pot of gold. Thank you for helping me. I couldn't have done that without you. All right, let's try it one more time. Let's find that shamrock. All right. Say the poem with me. Ready? Tricky little leprechaun doesn't want to share. Pick a pot of gold to see if his shamrock is there. Okay, where do you think it is? Yell it out as loud as you can. What color? Ooh, orange? Let's try orange. It wasn't there. That was a good guess, though. Can you guess again? Which color do you think it's hiding behind? Ooh, purple. I like purple. Let's try purple. It wasn't behind purple either. Okay, as loud as you can, which color do you think? Ooh, I see some friends guessing. Yellow. It was behind yellow last time. Let's try again. Nope, it wasn't there this time. All right. What color do you think it's behind? Maybe that new special color. Ooh, do you remember what it's called? Lime. Let's check behind the lime pot of gold. The shamrock was hiding behind the lime pot of gold. Thank you for helping me find the shamrock. I like playing those games. They're really fun. All right, friends. Yesterday I made a craft, and it looks like this. What does this look like? Does it look like a rainbow? It does. I want to show you how I made this. I bet you have all of the materials that I used at your house. So after school today, you could make your own rainbow. Something that I had to use to make my rainbow are scissors. Do you have scissors at your house? Scissors are really sharp, so we need to be extra careful when we use scissors. I would like to teach you a song that I sing when I use scissors to cut. If you don't have scissors with you, you can pretend with your fingers like this. And this is how the song goes. Open, shut, open, shut. That's the way we cut, cut, cut. Open, shut, open, shut. That's the way we cut, cut, cut. I like to sing that scissor song with my students at school. We sing it a lot because we do a lot of cutting with scissors. All right, so I have some paper that I used yesterday for another craft. Look at this paper. What are those? Did you say hearts? You're right. Yesterday I cut out lots of hearts and I put them on my window. So I don't want to waste the rest of this paper, so I can use my scissors like this to cut out some shapes for my rainbow. Can you help me sing the song again? Open, shut, open, shut. That's the way we cut, cut, cut. Open, shut, open, shut. That's the way we cut, cut, cut. Oh, you're such a good singer. Thanks for helping me. What shape did I just cut out? You remember what this is called? It's a rectangle. I can use my scissors again to cut some squares like that. Okay, now I have my black piece of paper, but I need something to help me. What can I use that's sticky to put this orange square on my black piece of paper? Could I use some glue? I think so. Do you have glue at your house? So remember, when we use glue, we have to take the lid off like this. And my glue's already twisted up a little bit, so it's ready to use. And then I put glue all over my orange square so it's nice and sticky. And then I can stick it on my paper like that. So when you make your rainbow today, you can do it how I did, or you can just stick the little squares all over. It's your project, so you get to decide how you want to do it. Okay, and then when I'm done with my glue, I gotta put my lid on like that so I can use it next time. Okay, so after school, you could make a rainbow art with glue and scissors and paper. Does that sound like fun? I think you'll have lots of fun doing that. All right, let's look at our caterpillars. You're not gonna believe how big they are. They're getting so big. So remember, a caterpillar is a baby insect. Ooh, and this one's green, like our color today. But our caterpillars don't look like babies anymore. Do you want to see how big they're getting? All right, here they are. Oh my goodness! Look at those big caterpillars! They're getting so big. Do you remember how many are in there? Let's count. They're easier to see now because they're so big. Can you help me count? One, two, 3, 4, 5 caterpillars. They're getting so big. I wonder how many more days it will take before they turn into butterflies. We'll have to keep watching them together to see. All right, I'm going to read you a story now. This one is called This Book Just Ate My dog. Does that sound like a crazy book?
It is. Remember, when we listen or read a book, these are some of the things that we do. You first choose a book to read. Here's our book. Then you find a good spot. You might have lots of comfy places in your house to read a book, like your bed or a couch, or maybe you want to sit on the floor to read a book, like this boy's doing. Then we turn the pages gently. We have to be really soft and gentle with books, don't we? And when we're done, we put the book back. Maybe your books go on a shelf or in a basket. So we put it away so we can read it again. Okay, remember, we look with our eyes, listen with our ears, and think about the words with our minds. So let's read This Book Just Ate My Dog by Richard Byrne. He wrote this story. And it goes like this. Bella was taking her dog for a stroll across the page when, look at her big dog, he's bigger than her, something very odd happened. Odd means something really weird or strange happened. What's happening to the dog? Where'd he go? Bella's dog disappeared. Where is he? I don't know. Hello, Bella. What's up? Said Ben. This book just ate my dog. Oh, I like Ben's balloon. That looks fun. Ben decided to investigate. That means he's gonna see what's happening. But Ben disappeared too. Uh-oh. Suddenly, help zoomed in. This says dog rescue. Do you think that this ambulance is going to find the dog? Then vanished. Nope, it disappeared too. Things were getting ridiculous. I'll just have to sort this out myself, thought Bella. See the police car and the fire truck? They're disappearing into the book too. But, burp. Who do you think burped? Sometime later, a note appeared. It read, "Dear reader, it would be lovely if you could kindly help us. Please turn this book on its side and shake, Bella." Okay, I need your help for this part. The note says we have to turn the book around like this and shake it. Can you help me like this? Shake that book. Shake, shake, shake. And shake and shake and shake. What's happening? All the things are coming out of the book. And one last little wiggle. Thank you, Bella. Everybody reappeared. Oh, they came back. And things got back to normal. Well, almost. Oh, what happened to the dog? Are his legs on top of his body? That's not where his legs go. That's a silly book, isn't it? Oh, one more note. Dear reader, please tell this book to promise not to be so naughty next time you read it. Thank you, Bella. And there's her upside down dog. The end. Did you like that story? That story's really silly. All right, friends, it's time for us to say goodbye. Can you help me sing our goodbye song with our clock? Here's our clock. Do you see the color green on there? I see two color greens. You see light green? And dark green? What was that word that we learned for light green? Do you remember? Lime. Can you say lime? Very good. All right, let's sing our goodbye song. It goes like this. Goodbye now, the clock says we're done. We'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye, everyone. Very good singing. Thank you for coming to school with me today. I hope you had lots of fun learning about the color green. This is my green sweater that I usually wear when it's Christmas time, but I wanted to wear it today for Green Day. Tomorrow we'll learn about the color blue. Do you like the color blue? A lot of friends like the color blue. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow. Have a really good day. Bye. See you next time. Bye.